been talking the talk. It's now time to walk the walk. This is the Lighthouse Theater. I'm Todd Grisham. And watching this live with me is Johnny Nelson.
The pleasure's always mine, my friend.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Tyson Fury. He stands an imposing 6'9" tall with a reach of 85 inches. And he'll be taking on, yes indeed, Muhammad Ali. 6'3". The Gypsy King himself. The Great. Walking has been done. It's time to start doing the walking.
This place is like a coliseum. When it's packed out, the fans are there. You can hear their punches. You can smell the sweat. The heat is second to none.
Good luck.
Promises of war. Let's see if they deliver. Counter punches for both these athletes. Don't want to trade shots. He fails to score with that left hook. One punch could change everything in this battle.
Left hand.
That bell could not have come soon enough. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations that just been hurt you, but it's not very good. Be smart, be strong. But obviously, you don't get sucked in. If you fight, you'll fight. Hold and tie him up. You can get your head cleared again, and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to cut you off. Make look so easy.
Here we go to the fourth round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. There's no doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. He can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics, they know that the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Counter left hand there. He misses with that jab.
Come out, pressure to David, that's not gonna happen, you gotta hope for him, you gotta bless him. your first blow shot. That's what he's gonna look like. He's hit. And you know when that's gonna bang it. You've got to be honest, but you've got to be confident.
Right. He just missed with that big right hand. The connect percentages have to be off the chart. I heard the phrase, finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
And you've got two fighters that are absolutely will come calm, because if you panic, you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked.
Very competitive round with 10 seconds left. What power punch to score? They've got the momentum, they've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
So they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
Fantastic last round. Let's see if he can keep his momentum going. This man stepped back for just a moment. There's a big difference between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
What you do with an aggressive fighter, what you do is you fight fire with fire. You either give it them back because that's where they're coming from.
Nice counter shot. Excellent display in that left hand. Good one.
For skill, tap for tap, that's a match made in heaven.
Can shoot with the left arm, good job. Good counter punching for both these fighters. That punch lands. Counter punching. Block that right hook. But doesn't score with it. Just missed with that hook. Push it away, 10 seconds to go. Good left corner that lands. He is down big time in the score. Every second, every minute of this fight is important. Every second, every minute, a big round is important. You cannot afford to lose it.
Say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
and he knows he's being hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. He will fight fire with fire. Hold him off. He's smart because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are done. He knows your legs are done.
Thank you.
back up on their feet, but I'm not sure why. Carries away that left hook. Punch, counter punch.
The best star part. You know what? The compliment now is down to them doing their job. Bring people around, meet the view, got fresh enough. Good attack.
Attributes to have in boxing has nothing to do with boxing. It's how well you can take a punch to the face.
This is when you get in the ring feeling like a King Kong, because you know you've got a chin that is not going to get bent.
Beautiful counter shot. There to stop the rally. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. That cut is going to cause some problems. They might want to call a doctor over.
Man, oh man.
There's the belt around the leg. What a round we just saw. Let's see what we've got in store for us here.
This is part of the game plan. You knew this was going to happen. Now you've got to stay still in your mind. You've got to think, right, don't get rattled. Don't get swayed by the crowd cheering or booing. Get straight in there, stick to your game plan, show your shot, and then let it go. That's your place.
Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on. There's a counter shot. So much for boxing. This is a fist fight. Only catching air with that hook. Good counter punch. Nice exchanges for both men. Here from both men. determined that they can walk through any punches that their opponent throws, and that's a very confident spot to be in.
Because you've got a good chin doesn't mean you've got leather skin. It means you can still get caught. So you've got to go for this point there, over the eyebrows, the cheekbone, and you've just got to try and cut them, skim it, up the speed. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson. Hi, Todd. Nice to be here with you.
And now it's time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali, who stands 6 foot 3 inches tall with a 78-inch reach. And across the ring to the Gypsy King, Tyson. Boxing match. This is going to be a fight. Gets out of the way of that left hand. Thank you. right round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
Dominance without a doubt makes it so easy.
Here's the belt start round two. There's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next round.
This is a thick, strong man style that he's got to get inside that long reach. Not many fights can do that. Shake your legs, and not here away from getting stopped. Above you, and so I've got to respect both of them.
How much confidence do you build when your opponents hit you with their best shot and you walk right through?
I've seen some fights with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move.
Yeah.
about the next round?
You got
know who the bigger power puncher is, there's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
I see certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone.
Forget tactics. They know that the second they touch you, done. That's where the problem comes.
Grisham, and there's nothing quite like the Empire Fight Camp, especially at night. Alongside me, former world champion Johnny Nelson.
You tried to give me a slip, didn't you, my friend? There was no way I was going to miss this.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Introducing first, it's Riddick Big Daddy Bun. 6'5", 240 pounds, with a reach of 81 inches. And he'll be taking on Muhammad Ali, 6'3" inches tall. I'll be fighting under. Expecting an all-out offensive display. You don't want to trade shots. Let's make a step back for just a moment.
Just to win for some time, they need to feel the blood, the crunch, they need to get that win.
He's been showing exceptional hands, by the way.
distinction between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor.
We've got some things so far. Extreme aggressive fighters, they can paralyze the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful. Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fight is not to give them what they want. Because they want to get you. Thank you.
competitive round with 10 seconds left. Fighter willing to sit down on these punches. They're arm punches. They're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. Perfect counter shot. Can they figure out the combination to this thing? Invite the team on jab.
I've been in some bullet fights. Trust me, I know what it feels like. You've got to be able to get off the surface. I love you in person, especially if you're a shooter in the crowd.
Round 7, here we go. They got battered last round. How do they turn their fortune? motions around. Speed. position. But if he's a better possessor, how do you do it?
Don't get stuck with him. Make him fight your fight. Hold and tie him up just until your head plays again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
In the early rounds of a fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power. And I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
hard. Sometimes when they're going to ring with fights like that, and you punch them, you just want to run. You want your spaceship to come and lift you out there because you think, what the hell am I going to do now?
Back up.
an issue for this fighter. He continues to be aggressive as the rounds go on.
Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fighter is to give them what they want. Because they want to get there, they want you to stand up, don't play with them, and have a challenge. That's what they do in the gym. Every single day they win. What you've got to do is you've got to frustrate them after you set this up. Get out of the way. And they'll get so angry, so frustrated, because they can't work.
Nice exchanges from both men in this one.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. It's like a match made in heaven.
Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Grisham and all the seats have been sold. We're live at the Empire Fight Camp. Next to me, of course, is Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Sean. Hi to everybody back home.
Olympic Big Daddy Bones, a 1988 Olympic silver medalist, a two-time heavyweight champion, and one of the best inside fighting heavyweights there's ever been. Rocky Martin.
underneath the moonlight, and what a fight it should be.
You can hear the noise, you can hear the fans. I've been to many, many firefighters.
Thank you.
same time. That guy carries so much power. Of course they're going to look like messed up each other. It makes the night a little bit shorter.
You don't need to get any extra for overtime.
Nice counter shot. Exchange punches.
seen certain fighters that can return on just their power alone.
Forget tactics, they know that when they touch you,
so that's where the problem comes from.
United States is involved in this.
So close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
Thank you.
dominated so far, but how does this match get turned around? I seriously hope it's...
Thank you.
change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they hope to knock them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and relax. What you can do in the gym, you can do it in the practice.
You've got to protect that. You've also got to get your shot. You can bang through.
Nice exchanges from both. He's showing exceptional chin, by the way.